In a shocking incident in Mumbai, a Shiv Sena MLA misbehaved and humiliated a municipal contractor there after accusing him of not cleaning a drain properly. In a video that's gone viral now, the contractor is shoved into the drain water by Sena's Chandivali MLA, Dilip Lande's staff. He later ordered workers to throw garbage on him. The contractor is seen sitting in a pool of rainwater, and supporters of the Sena MLA are seen piling dirt, garbage on him. In fact, the MLA can be heard shouting at the contractor, justifying his actions here. Lande later said that he had to punish this contractor for not doing his job properly. The MLA said he had received many complaints regarding waterlogging after rains that lashed the metropolis, and he didn't do his duty right. Here's the MLA who's ordered his men to shower slush and garbage on this contractor.
जिनकी जिम्मेदारी है वो कोई यहाँ पे नहीं है, लेकिन लोगों ने मेरे ऊपर विश्वास रख के मेरे को विधायक बनाया, इसलिए मेरी जिम्मेदारी, मेरा फर्ज पूरा करने के लिए मैं यहाँ पे पूरे शिवसेना के शाखा प्रमुख शिवसैनिकों को लेके यहाँ पे रास्ते पे आया हूँ, गटर साफ करने के लिए आया हूँ। ये काम ठेकेदार को दिया था, ठेकेदार ने ये काम नहीं किया, इसलिए मैं खुद रस्ते पे उतर के ये गटर साफ करने का काम कर रहा हूँ। चार पांच दिन से ये संजय नगर सुंदरबाग के मेरे लोगों को ये गटर में से जाना पड़ रहा है, ये गंदगी में से जाना पड़ रहा है, इसलिए मैं खुद लोगों के लिए यहाँ पे गटर साफ करने का काम कर रहा हूँ। और जिसका जिम्मेदारी है वो ठेकेदार ने ये काम किया नहीं है, इसलिए ठेकेदार को पकड़ के यहाँ लाया हूँ।
Mustafa Sheikh joining us live from Mumbai. Mustafa, this is shocking and appalling, against human rights. And this MLA has the audacity, Dilip of the Shiv Sena has the audacity saying it's his responsibility to ensure that his men work right. But what he's done here is nothing short of criminal. Showering garbage on this contractor, whatever be his fault.
Well, Nabila, if you look at it one way, that it is his responsibility and his party's responsibility because they are in power in the state government and in the BMC corporation. So if the work was not done well, the contractors or the other people could have been brought to accountability before the monsoons. To take law into your own hands and try to punish the corporator or the contractor from, and he's standing right there being an elected representative in the video, is clearly seen instructing people. So this kind of sends out a lawlessness message to other people, to other workers, who can then resort to assaulting these contractors, because there are a lot of complaints of floodings and drainage not being cleaned coming up because of huge rainfall happening in Mumbai, and there is reporting of waterlogging. But at the same point of time, it doesn't mean that people should take law into their own hands.
Well,
especially
he is a lawmaker himself. This Mustafa, what we see here is absolutely not pleasing. He should apologize, if not the least. Thank you very much for joining us. Now, rift in the Rajasthan Congress escalates as Sachin Pilot camp claims that their phones are being tapped. The allegations made by the MLA Ved Prakash Solanki has now churned out some fresh political drama in the state, as the opposition BJP has now cornered the Gehlot government seeking an explanation on the phone tapping charges. Meanwhile, Congress top brass is trying to resolve the dissent between Pilot and Gehlot. Sources say that party president Sonia Gandhi is actively looking into the matter to resolve differences between Gehlot and Pilot. India Today learns that Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi Vadra is now likely to meet the MIFT Pilot today to address his concerns, while Congress leader Ajay Makin has said that a cabinet expansion is likely on the cards. According to sources, 4 to 5 MLAs of Sachin Pilot camp will be given ministerial berth. Some MLAs will also be given posts within the party, and sources also reveal that after reconciliation, party wants Sachin Pilot to enter into central politics.
देखिए, वर्तमान कांग्रेस सरकार अवैध तरीके से जनप्रतिनिधियों के टेलीफोन टैप करती है और उसे अपने राजनीतिक हथियार के रूप में उपयोग करती है, ऐसा अनेक बार अनेक लोगों ने आरोप लगाए हैं। मुझे लगता है कि कांग्रेस को, कांग्रेस की सरकार और सरकार के मुखिया को इसका स्पष्टीकरण करना चाहिए।
कुछ लोगों ने कहा है, हमारे विधायक साथियों ने भी कहा है, उधर के जो विधायक साथी हैं उन्होंने भी ये चीज कही है कि फोन टेपिंग हो रहे हैं अधिकारियों को, किसी भी तरह पे उच्च अधिकारियों द्वारा या आदि से नीचे वाले अधिकारियों को भी ऐसा हो रहा है, उनको डराने धमकाने जैसी बात सामने आई है।
सीडी फोन टैपिंग और इस तरीके की, मैं जो समझ पाया कि अशोक गहलोत जी की फितरत में भी है और उनकी सरकार में भी है, जब वो अपने व्यक्तियों को नहीं बख्शते हैं तो स्वाभाविक तौर पर राजनीतिक प्रतिद्वंदियों के खिलाफ या ऐसे जो संगठन जो उनकी टारगेट पे होते हैं वो अपने भाषणों में भी व्यक्त करते हैं और अपने एक्शन में भी करते हैं। और इसमें मुझे लगता नहीं है कि कहीं किसी किस्म की पार्टी की भीतरी राजनीति, और एक स्वाभाविक तौर पर कांग्रेस का, मैं ये मानता हूं जिस तरीके की राजनीति ये लोग करते हैं उसी का हिस्सा है।
Now politics over, Digvijay Singh's contentious remarks on the abrogation of Article 370 escalates furthermore as Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad now attacked the Congress leadership, questioning its silence. He asked the grand old party to clear its stand on Article 370. Ravi Shankar Prasad, in his tweet, asked whether the party wants restoration of Article 370 as indicated by Digvijay Singh. This comes a day after BJP shared a sensational audio clip in which Digvijay Singh is heard saying that the decision to revoke Article 370 and downgrading Jammu and Kashmir from a state to a union territory is extremely sad. He goes on to say that the Congress party will certainly have a relook at the Modi government's decision. In fact, the Congress leader there remained defiant while speaking to India Today. He said that Congress had opposed the decision to scrap Article 370 in the parliament, adding that the manner in which the decision was implemented was wrong.
Democracy was not there in Kashmir when they revoked Article 370. Then insaniyat was not there because they put everyone behind bars. And Kashmiriyat is something which is basically the fundamentals of secularism. Because in a Muslim majority state, there was a Hindu Raja, and both worked together. In fact, the reservation in Kashmir was given to the Kashmiri Pandits in government services. So therefore, the decision of revoking Article 370 and reducing the statehood of JNK is extremely, I would say, sad decision. And the Congress party would certainly have to have a re-look on this issue.
Now, after Mukul Roy's Ghar Vapsi, speculations are now rife that more TMC turncoats will follow suit. This comes after BJP leader Rajiv Banerjee held a meeting with TMC State Secretary Kunal Ghosh on Saturday. But Rajiv Banerjee, however, denied speculations of him returning to the TMC's fold, saying that he's still with the BJP and it was just a courtesy meet with Kunal Ghosh. Rajiv had openly revolted against Bengal BJP unit after he slammed Suvendu Adhikari's demand of precedence rule in Bengal. He, along with Mukul Roy and Shamik Bhattacharya, had also skipped a key meeting of the party chaired by State Unit Chief Dilip Ghosh just a few days ago.
What exactly transpired today?
No, it is nothing. It is just a courtesy visit with one of my friend come brother. So I have visited his house. It's a courtesy visit, nothing else.
You have mentioned in your Facebook message that you have certain reservations about your own party. Have you been able to air it?
What I have mentioned in my Facebook, definitely it is my Facebook. So that reservation is there.
Can we say Rajiv Banerjee is firmly in the BJP right now?
Sorry?
You're firmly with the BJP. Any plans of switching?
Yeah, till now I'm with BJP. There is no doubt about it.
The fact that you are meeting Kunal Ghosh today?
No, this is only a courtesy visit. Nothing else.
And what do you have to say about Mukul Roy's entry into the Trinamool once again?
That is his own decision. So he can take his own decision. So till now I have not taken any decision.
And we have Kunal Ghosh with us. Kunal, just tell us, what is kind of meeting that took place today? So much of speculation.
Absolutely courtesy visit. Rajiv came here to meet his relative and then made a call whether I am in my office or not. I said yes, I am here. So he can.
Is there any possible, any other political possibility?
No comment.
एक आध लोगों को कोई प्रॉब्लम होगा तो जा सकते, उनका पर्सनल प्रॉब्लम है, पार्टी का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं।
20 से 25 MLA जो है जाने की फिराक में, वो कल खुद कह रहे थे।
ये तो पहले से भी कहानी सुन रहे हैं, 5 साल से MP जा रहे हैं, MLA जा रहे हैं, उल्टा आ गया 50 MLA। इसलिए समझे BJP ऐसी पार्टी नहीं कि कोई भी आएगा कोई भी चला जाएगा। एक आध लोग आएंगे, जरूर जाएंगे, इससे पार्टी को कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला।
Now, Shayati Narula explains more on who all are the TMC turncoats who are upset with the BJP currently. Let's take a listen.
Let's take a look at who all are the turncoats that are upset with the BJP. Rajiv Banerjee, one, indirectly criticized Shivendu Adhikari. Let's get you number two. You've got Sabyasachi Datta. He claimed that BJP couldn't reach out to the voters. So he could be probably another turncoat. We have Sumitra Khan as well on your screens right now. He quit local BJP WhatsApp group but rejoined later. Shanali Guha apologized to Mamata Banerjee. She's another one for leaving the TMC. Then you have Dibyendu Biswas on your screen. Slam the BJP over TMC MLA arrest. Biswajit Das, he skipped the party meeting that was conveyed by Dilip Ghosh. So we've got mega rebellion that is going on in the BJP right there in Bengal.
Now, socialism weds Mamata Banerjee. It may sound bizarre, but well, that's the fact. This is really happening. A groom named Socialism and a bride named Mamata is indeed going to get married in Tamil Nadu's Salem. And their marriage has now become the talk of the town. In fact, their wedding card has gone viral on social media. Let's take a look at this report.
Socialism weds Mamata Banerjee. Communism, Leninism and Marxism to attend the marriage. This is not a joke. A wedding invitation of a groom named Socialism and a bride named Mamata Banerjee has gone viral on the internet. The couple is all set to tie the knot on 13th June. This wedding in Tamil Nadu's Salem has grabbed eyeballs because of the couple's name. Socialism is the son of A. Mohan, who is the district secretary of Communist Party of India in Salem. While Mohan's family is a staunch supporter of CPI, his daughter-in-law's family is a hardcore Congress supporter. The Communists and Mamata Banerjee might be at loggerheads in West Bengal, but this time the two of them are on the same page, and that too on a wedding invite. With Akshay Nath, Bureau Report, India Today.
Now, as COVID cases continue the downward trend in the national capital, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has announced more relaxations from the curbs. As per the new guidelines now, all the markets and malls will now be open between 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. from tomorrow. Restaurants and public transport will also be allowed to be run with 50% capacity. Public transport can ply with half the seating capacity, and only 2 passengers are allowed in auto rickshaws and taxis. However, this is being permitted for 1 week on a trial basis. If cases increase, then the government might impose stricter restrictions. He's further announced that social, political and religious gatherings have been prohibited. Weddings will not be allowed in public places like banquet halls or hotels. It will be permitted only in closed spaces with not more than 20 people. Spas, gyms, yoga institutes, parks, gardens will also remain closed for public to break the chain of the virus.
कल 5 बजे के बाद से सारी एक्टिविटीज़ अलाउड हैं, एक्सेप्ट कुछ एक्टिविटीज़ हैं जो बिल्कुल प्रोहिबिटेड हैं, वो बिल्कुल अलाउड नहीं है, और कुछ एक्टिविटीज़ हैं जो रिस्ट्रिक्टेड तरीके से अलाउड हैं। सारे स्कूल बंद रहेंगे, कॉलेज बंद रहेंगे, एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस बंद रहेंगे, कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूशंस बंद रहेंगे, सोशल, पॉलिटिकल, स्पोर्ट्स, एंटरटेनमेंट, एकेडमिक, कल्चरल, रिलीजियस, फेस्टिवल, इससे रिलेटेड जितनी गैदरिंग्स हैं कोई भी गैदरिंग अलाउड नहीं होगी। स्विमिंग पूल बंद रहेंगे, स्टेडियम बंद रहेंगे, स्पोर्ट्स कॉम्प्लेक्स बंद रहेंगे, सिनेमा थिएटर मल्टीप्लेक्स बंद रहेंगे, एंटरटेनमेंट पार्क्स एम्यूजमेंट पार्क्स वाटर पार्क्स बंद रहेंगे, बैंक्वेट हॉल्स ऑडिटोरियम्स असेंबली हॉल्स बंद रहेंगे, बिजनेस टू बिजनेस एग्जीबिशंस स्पाज जिमनेजियम योगा इंस्टीट्यूट्स बंद रहेंगे और पब्लिक पार्क्स और गार्डन्स बंद रहेंगे। ये प्रोहिबिटेड एक्टिविटीज़ हैं, ये बिल्कुल पूरी तरह से बंद हैं। जो एक्टिविटीज़ पार्टली अलाउड हैं, रिस्ट्रिक्टेड एक्टिविटीज़ हैं, वो ये हैं। सरकारी दफ्तर, जो पिछले हफ्ते स्थिति थी वही कि ग्रुप ए ऑफिसर्स 100% अटेंडेंस और बाकी सबकी 50% अटेंडेंस। लेकिन जो एसेंशियल एक्टिविटीज़ है, जैसे अस्पताल हैं, दूसरी पुलिस है, ये वो सब 100% वो पूरी तरह से चालू रहेंगी। प्राइवेट ऑफिसर्स जितने हैं वो 50% कैपेसिटी पे काम करेंगे, 9 बजे से 5 बजे तक काम करेंगे और कोशिश करेंगे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा वर्क फ्रॉम होम की। जितने मार्केट्स हैं, मार्केट कॉम्प्लेक्स हैं, मॉल्स हैं, वो अब पिछले हफ्ते ऑड इवन था, कल से पूरी तरह से सारी दुकानें खुल सकती हैं 10 बजे, लेकिन 10 बजे से 8 बजे तक शाम को। और जो रेस्टोरेंट हैं वो 50% सीटिंग कैपेसिटी पे काम करेंगे। ये एक हफ्ता हम लोग देखेंगे मार्केट्स और रेस्टोरेंट्स का। एक हफ्ते में अगर केसेस बढ़ते नहीं हैं तो इसको चालू रखेंगे, लेकिन अगर हमें लगता है कि दिल्ली में कोरोना के केसेस बढ़ने लग गए फिर से, तो हमें इस पे फिर से रिस्ट्रिक्शन और सख्त करनी पड़ेगी।
ये तो गुड न्यूज़ है और हम चाहते हैं कि हमारा क्लाइंट एज यूजल पहले जैसे आ जाए। हमसे जो हो पाएगा वो हम कर रहे हैं, गुड प्रिकॉशन कर रहे हैं, डिस्पोजेबल यूज़ कर रहे हैं, सैनिटाइजर कर रहे हैं, टेम्परेचर नाप के ही अंदर आने दे रहे हैं हम सब क्लाइंट को।
2 महीने से जो व्यापार बंद था, जो व्यापार बंद होने के कारण बहुत समस्याएं जेनरेट हो रही थी, लेकिन इस समय ये एक अच्छा मूव है जिससे इकोनॉमी को बहुत अच्छा पुशअप मिलेगा और मोटिवेशन पॉजिटिव फैक्टर्स मार्केट के अंदर दोबारा आएंगे। अगर हम पूरे दिल्ली की बात करें, जो 2 से 2.5 करोड़ की जनता है, जो छोटी छोटी मार्केटें हैं, जो अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर है, वहाँ पे सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग रखना थोड़ा सा मुश्किल होगा।